Joining me on All These Things TV. If this is your first time, welcome. And if it's not, hey girlfriend, it's good to see you again. If this is your first time and you like what you see, please be sure to hit the subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. So how are y'all doing today? I hope you guys are doing great. I am here with a pregnancy update. This is week 31 through week 32. We are trucking on through. We are making it to the end. And when I tell y'all, I can feel it. This update is a lot of blurred. A lot of these past 2 weeks have been feeling the same. I haven't had any super symptoms, but I am going to share with you guys what I have going on. So let's go ahead and get right into it. Let's talk about baby anatomically for week 31, and then we'll get into how I'm feeling with week 31. And you know how it goes. You know, y'all know the routine by now. Y'all know what's up. Week 31 baby is as big as an asparagus. Look at that. Baby is going through major brain and nerve development. Eye development too. Baby's irises now react to light. All five of baby's senses are in working order. Baby is about 15.2 to 16.7 inches long and weighs about 2.5 to 3.8 pounds this month. Baby is getting so big that he or she is probably crowding your lungs. Yes, I talked about that in my last update. So that's baby anatomically. That's what's going on with little baby eating. He's growing and I'm always out of breath. He's always pushing on my lungs. And I started to feel concerned about it because I'm like, I'm feeling heart palpitations because I'm out of breath. But it's not all the time. So I just chuck it up to him taking up all the space in my area. Like I said earlier, the days are starting to blur together. Everything is kind of just the same. I'm just managing. Being big, Humpty Dumpty-ing, we gonna say that. Humpty Dumpty-ing around. I finished my birth plan. Of course, I'm pretty sure you guys have seen it. If you haven't seen it, I'll have it up here. I always never know which side with that song. So you guys can check it out. Please be sure to check out the birth plan if that's something you're interested in. I finished my birth plan in week 31. My doctor's appointments are every 2 weeks now, and I mentioned that, but they're always super short. It's like, oh, hey, this is what's going on with the baby. You got anything going on? You good? Okay, well, see you next time. And you know, it's tedious when my doctor and my hospital is 30 minutes away. For me to drive, for them to ask me if I'm okay, it's like, bruh, you could have called me. You could have called me and asked me if I was good. You didn't have to see me. But they do measure my belly to see if I'm growing according to plan based off of the weeks and check the baby's heartbeat. And I know he's moving. He's fine. He's perfectly fine. But my dreams have gotten pretty crazy. In week 31, I had a dream that my grandmother, my Gammy, she had gotten a hold of an airplane. And she flew this airplane. And I was in it. And she took it on the highway, but she was on the wrong, she got on the wrong ramp. She was going up the ramp that cars come down, so we had to swerve a semi. We swerved a semi and turned around. And the crazy thing is, it wasn't a regular size plane. It was a legit, like, it was like a toy plane. I don't know how we got in it, but we was in it. And we took off, and then we ended up in the air. We kind of dipped in the sky. And then at this point, at first, our heads were out and exposed, and then she put stuff over. It was me, Cadence, and my grandmother. And so Gammy put a little, a window over her head so she could fly. And then Cadence had one, and then I had one, but mine was too small and cramped because, mind you, we're in a toy flying airplane. And so I'm just stuck like this, and I'm like, I can't do this. And then it flashed to the next scene, and I was driving in a semi-truck with Robin Thicke. I don't know what it is about these celebrities coming in my dreams, but I was telling him about everything that I was going through. I don't even know what I was going through at the time, but whatever I was going through, I was really explaining it to him, and he started getting too close to me, and it was weird and awkward, but he tried to make a move on me, and then I woke up. So the crazy dreams are still here. They still popping. One thing in week 31, is that I have started to have lightning crash. I know it's a little early because Eden hasn't dropped down too much. But what I have noticed is In the evening time is when he gets the most active. He gets active around like 7:30. From like 7:30 to 9, he is party time for Eden is between 7:30 and 9:30. And boy, I have to sit still that whole time because my stomach will be stretched. I'll be hurting. I'll get kicked in my lungs. I'll get kicked in my cervix. And I'm just like, why he in there partying? It's terrible. But lightning crotch is something that I started dealing with in the evening, especially when he wants to have his daily party. And that's week 31 pretty much. So let's go ahead and get into week 32, shall we? Baby is as big as a squash. Yeah, baby is getting ready for his or her descent and is likely in the head down position now. And baby is probably feeling even more cramped. Still growing. Your baby weighs in at Still growing. Your baby weighs in at 2.5 to 3.8 pounds and measures about 15.2 to 16.7 inches. It's kind of about the same for these 2 weeks. I feel you moving down there. What's up? At 32 weeks, baby's birth still seems kind of far away, but you and baby are physically ready in a lot of ways, just in case there is an early arrival. We have 7 weeks or less than 7 weeks until we meet this little boy. So nowadays, I am a lot more tired. I have made it my job regularly to take naps. Like week 32, this past week, I have, outside of what's going on with my husband has, if you guys watch my weekly vlogs, you guys know that Fago's leg went out on him. So he's hopping on crutches. And if you guys follow me on social media, I put it on social media too. He's hopping on crutches. He has this brace that goes from, you know, the top of his thigh all the way down to his ankle that keeps his knee straight. So I'm already tired because I'm creating life. And then I have to, you know, pick up the slack because he can't do as much as he usually does because he's on crutches. So I have to help him get in and out of the car on top of putting Cadence in and out of the car. So grocery shopping is difficult. We'll figure it out. This week I've been feeling really, really crampy. And it kind of started to worry me a little bit, but you know, I've been chugging water because I've been thirsty. I'm thirsty. I'm always thirsty. That's literally one of the cravings that I have. Ice and water. Not ice water. I want a cup of ice and then I want a bottle of room temperature water. I know I'm probably crazy, but I just want ice and water, not together. Separately. Instead of going to cornstarch like I did with Cadence, I've switched over to just munching ice. I don't even want to start cornstarch, even though the more I talk about it, it does kind of sound appetizing. And it was around this time that I started eating cornstarch with Cadence. It does sound really good now that I'm talking about it. I might have to get some this weekend. Don't judge me because I ate it with Cadence and it was so fire. That sounds really good. There's not much I can wear, and I made a status about this on Facebook a couple of weeks ago. I was like, I don't want to be the sweatpant lady. I need somewhere where I can find some cute leggings. So I've just turned into wearing leggings. I have leggings on today. If I'm not wearing leggings, I'm not wearing anything. Or I'm wearing sweats. I'm very limited on what I can wear. Flats, flowy shirts, and leggings. And I'm so glad that the spring is here because now I can wear the maxi dresses. I might pull out one of these maxi dresses this weekend. If this weather keeps doing what it's doing, it's gonna hit the 80s today. If it keeps going like that and it's like that this weekend, Christian will be a pregnant lady in a maxi dress. I've been starting to feel weary. Not in a way like I'm depressed or sad or like, oh, give me my body back, kinda. It's not like I'm in a negative weary. It's just like, okay, we're getting close. Okay, I'm tired. Okay, my body is, we getting to the point where we starting to feel like we touching the limit here. And so it's like, oh, I gotta get out the bed. Oh, okay, I gotta get in the shower. Oh, let me bend over and wash my leg. Like, it's just, I'm just kind of weary in terms of, it's just like, okay, this baby has everything. In terms of my body, he's taking everything as he should. You know, that's just kind of part of the process. But it's just, I'm just weary. I'm just starting to feel like, okay, I'm ready. So as the weeks continue, I'm only 32 weeks. So as the weeks continue, I know I'm going to feel like that more and more. But this week, I just started to feel like, okay, woo. And, you know, and it's crazy because it actually took me to get to this point to really realize that I was pregnant. Like, I've been talking about it all this time, but it's like, now it's really hit home for me. Like, girl, this is a person. You know, you can't stretch and turn because there's a person inside of you. And I know that I've been talking about it and the realization has hit me in pieces, but I think I feel like I have a full, complete realization now that I'm like, my body is like, okay, we're getting close. So that's good, and it's good news. You know, it's not even bad news. It's all good news. It's just, you know, my body responding to carrying a child and carrying life. Yeah, that's pretty much my update. I hope you guys enjoy. I kind of breezed through this one these past couple weeks. So the next one is going to be week 33 and 34. We are in the 8th month. It's not going to be too much longer. Thank you guys for watching. If you're interested in any of my other updates, I will have the playlist in the description box below. Other than that, please like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye.